Hey everyone, my name is Kylie and I will be taking you around today doing a day in my life at Johns Hopkins University as a junior majoring in medicine, science, and humanities.
I'm headed over to my organic chemistry lab class, but first I'm stopping at Levering Café for a lavender mocha. And now on to the Undergraduate Teaching Lab, or UTL as we call it. UTL has beautiful, light-filled labs for biology, chemistry, biophysics, neuroscience, and more. Organic Chemistry Lab is definitely a tough and challenging class, but we do lots of fun things, like make banana oil, for instance. I'm done with the lab, and now I'm headed to Brody Learning Commons for a little bit of studying. Brody is a really popular study spot for students. There are plenty of places to settle in and work on your own or with friends. I need some outside time, and I hear there are some special guests on campus today. I'm going to go grab lunch with some of my friends at Busboys and Poets, but there are other great places to eat on and around campus, including our two dining halls, Charles Market, and other restaurants located down St. Paul Street.
I just wanted to talk to you a little bit about why medicine, science, and humanities, or as we abbreviate it here at Hopkins, MSH. It's an interdisciplinary program and major that really focuses on exactly what the title describes: medicine, science, and humanities. So the great thing about this major is that it is super flexible, and we really get to choose what classes we want to take within these three fields. So for example, for the science aspect of this major, all we have to do is take three science courses, and these can be any courses you want, actually. A lot of pre-med students who major in this major easily cover those science requirements. Another thing that we must take are two introduction courses for MSH, and these courses are really great, and they offer a really good picture of what medical humanities really is. So examples of these courses in the past and ones that I've taken include death and dying, and how is that portrayed throughout history. Another class that I took is Intro to Bioethics, which is really popular for a lot of people majoring in MSH to take, because a lot of us are also bioethics minors, and it ties great into the program. And we also have to take three humanities courses. One of them needs to be an upper level. We also have to take a foreign language through the intermediate level. And finally, we have to take four courses in a focus area. And what's great is that there's 17 different focus areas you can pick from. Mine is history, because I really enjoy learning about history. And so this is another great thing about MSH, is that because of the flexibility and the courses that I can take, and just really the flexibility and the overlap it has with some pre-med courses regarding the science requirement, it's allowed me to graduate early and really focus on other pursuits that I enjoy, such as volunteering in clinical settings, hopefully working a clinical job in my gap year, and doing research. And so let's talk about research. Hopkins is really big on research, as we know, and so many students here do research because of the plentiful opportunities that are being offered. I'm working on a senior thesis, and what I'm looking into is ECMO machines and how they're used in the neonatal intensive care unit, and really the history behind these machines and the bioethical questions that surround using such invasive technology to save the lives of fragile neonatal infants. The department has done so much for me. They've helped me find a research advisor at the medical campus who specializes in pediatric palliative care. I think this research has really taught me so much about what I'm interested in regarding the medical field.
Classes are done for today, so let me tell you about some of what I do outside of class.
One of the central focuses of my experiences at Hopkins has been the Hopkins Model United Nations team, which we like to abbreviate to HOTMUN. And today we actually have training, and I'm currently vice president of the club, and I thought it'd be fun to do a guest training. So I'll be helping out our new training directors this year.
When I have time, I also like to play piano in the Shriver Hall practice rooms. They are available for all students. You just have to sign up. That's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel.